What is SolidStart? Is it set to challenge NextJS's way of doing things? Is SolidStart the shape of things to come? Well, first, let's look at what is SolidStart. In short, SolidStart is SolidJS's foundational meta framework. Let's break that into manageable bits. SolidJS is a front-end framework with a syntax similar to React's. It uses JSX. Unlike React, Solid uses signals to manage reactivity. I've covered Solid in more depth elsewhere if you want to explore it more. Now, what is a meta framework? A meta framework adds backend capabilities to a front-end JavaScript framework. There are many reasons to do so, including loading speed, SEO, user experience. And examples of meta frameworks include SvelteKit, Remix, Nuxt, and more. And of course, the solution that started the whole concept, Next.js, which builds on top of React. Next.js provides an all-in-one solution for routing, server-side generation, static generation, request caching, and more. And the company behind Next.js, Vercel, also provides hosting. This means that Vercel can ensure that Next.js works perfectly with its hosting services because of the fact that Next.js is a cohesive whole, a monolith, if you will. And so far, all the alternative meta frameworks have followed Next.js's direction. SolidStart, however, is taking a different path. Ryan Cognato, SolidJS's creator, announced SolidStart's first stable release. He entitled the talk, "The Shape of Frameworks to Come." That title shows that SolidStart hopes to usher in a new paradigm. They want to change how developers build frameworks. So what is this new path that SolidStart is taking? Well, as the framework states, SolidStart is a composable meta framework. What does that even mean? As I mentioned, Next.js is opinionated. For example, you can't change how routing works without writing a load of code. SolidStart, on the other hand, is a set of building blocks that you can swap in or out. There is Serval to serialize data between the server and the client, Vite, which manages code bundling, Nitro, the next generation server toolkit, and Vinci, which combines Vite and Nitro and provides routing. Now, each of these is worth a video on its own. Nitro in particular provides a lot of useful features, for example, file system routing, caching, or an SQL database layer. It provides a key value abstraction to interact with a tool like Redis. It provides adapters for major hosting providers like AWS and Vercel and Cloudflare and Netlify. And this means that SolidStart can run in the server environment of your choice. To quote the release blog post, SolidStart is designed to deploy SolidJS apps to a variety of providers. That's thanks to the different libraries that make up SolidStart, and to me, that's a very open source type of approach, a collaborative effort where different libraries and blocks contribute features to the whole, to SolidStart. These libraries are what allow SolidJS's launch post to boast that SolidStart supports client render mode, server-side rendering, static site generation, out-of-order streaming, optimistic UI, key-based cache invalidation, progressively enhanced forms, API routes, parallelized nested route data fetching, single-flight mutation, suspense, and transitions. And all the technologies and features chosen to make up SolidStart's features look very exciting. And if you do need something different or something more, you can swap out these building blocks for other blocks if you're so inclined. And that is why SolidStart is composable. Unlike Next.js, it doesn't lock you into any technological choices. But on a personal note, I'm not sure I want to swap out building blocks. I like Next.js's convenience, even if it does have drawbacks. But that's okay, because I'm not really SolidStart's target audience, at least not right now. And that brings us to SolidStart's name, more specifically to the start part of the name. As the blog post states, SolidStart is designed first and foremost to be a starter. Now, what does that mean? The blog post also says that this is a framework designed for builders and people who have their own opinions. That's what we mean by the shape of frameworks to come. SolidStart won't be the last solid framework. We've already seen people build meta frameworks on top of it. So it seems to me that SolidStart also sees itself as a building block, a part of something greater. But let's circle back to one of the first questions. Is SolidStart the shape of frameworks to come? Now, I have no doubt that there will be a slew of opinionated frameworks building on top of SolidStart. But will other non-SolidJS frameworks follow this direction? Now, don't get me wrong, it's an exciting direction. But SolidJS isn't the powerhouse that React is. It has a lot of exciting concepts. The most important one is its use of signals for fine-grained reactivity. But I don't see non-SolidJS meta frameworks going through major rewrites in order to follow in SolidState's footsteps. Even though NextJS would do well to increase its support for solutions other than Vercel. And if they choose to do so, SolidState's composable model might be the way forward. Now, has SolidState piqued your interest? If so, the next step along the way is to understand how SolidJS works and what it brings to the table. And that's what I've explained in this video. I'll see you there.